partnered with different schools privately. Mm-hmm. They give us time, we go to their schools. They give us maybe two times in a month, we go to schools and we get these different kids. We teach them how to code, create different things that they have in the head.
Previously, implementers of the Africa Code Week would teach children computer programming from their respective schools. But the outbreak of COVID-19 and the subsequent closure of schools forced implementers of the program to reach children through teachers. However, this laid bare different challenges that stood in the way of developing children's digital skills.
It can be spread if we improve the digital infrastructure in the country. It's very thin. Very few people have the gadgets.
Internet is extremely expensive. And now we are moving to the digital. So if there is no internet, this is not going to move smoothly. And maybe some companies are closing down and here and there. So like our options are, they keep getting less and less.
Prosi Wanyana, the executive director of Mindset Coders, the local implementers of the Africa Coding Week, notes that there is need to roundtable discussions between internet service providers and the government on the issue.
You're paying too much for too less. And I think maybe the government could step in and look at the service providers and maybe get how to deal with them. If the service providers say maybe we are too expensive because maybe the taxes are high, and maybe they can come together in an agreement and come to a specific price, and maybe they have a starting point.
Coding has been hailed as one of the initiatives through which 21st century skills like critical thinking and problem solving are honed.
How do you break your problem into bits and solve it slowly or bits by bits? That is problem solving that you learn from coding. When you're coding, you learn to think as a computer. That is computational thinking. When you're coding, you learn critical thinking. That is also a lifetime skill. When you're coding, you learn resilience. So all these five skills that I've mentioned, and there's more, they are part of the skills you learn as you learn how to code. And these are skills that we take for life.
Up to 20,000 children and 1,500 teachers and volunteers have been imparted with computer programming skills across the country since 2015. Story by Benan Ojambo for the news.